directions towards this, and there is a paper going forward to Audit and Risk Committee on Monday, which explains this and gives the assurance that it is within the law and we are within statute, and the external auditor is okay with this. And the paper then, the reason it's going to Audit and Risk on Monday is it has to go into our Treasury Management Strategy, which will go to full council for approval in March. So you will always be, you will all be part of that approval process. The reason we've done it is obviously to make savings early on in the first 10 years. So we've made £2.59 million saving each year for the next 10 years. 10 years on from that, we will have to increase the amount that we repay. But 10 years on from that, we will hope that we're not in the council's, council doesn't have a financial situation as it does now. As we get further along, you know, we will monitor the MTFS, the interim financial strategy, each year. And if needs be, we will put growth in future years.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Any questions or comments?
Thank you, Chair. Chair, how far can you profile the debt and backloading such a length of time without there being an increase in the rate of interest that we're going to pay for the debt and how much time? Or rather, how can you find a lender who's prepared to do that?
So this is all lending that we've already got, on board. And this money is that it's the money that the council sets aside, so we actually set it aside in our own budget. So it's quite complicated. This is the third time we've done this, we didn't do it actually this year before the year before. Every council's done this more or less in the country. And every year, each council tries to find another way of how to reprofile it. So what we're doing really is, we've got the same amount of debt over 33 years, but all we've done is we've said we're paying less at the start and more at the end. So it's still the same amount of debt.
Yeah, I got that bit. But you've got to service the debt on a yearly basis from year to year, haven't you? And obviously someone, you've got to pay the piper at some point. Someone that's actually has an IOU, and we have debts with that. So regardless of whether we've held it or whether we've gone out through the reprofile and found someone else, so it's the same lender or not, the debt's got to be serviced, as I said. So have we renegotiated the terms of the contracts with the current lender? Is that how it's worked effectively?
No. We haven't.
And this is,
I might not be able to give you all the information on this. If you do need some more information, I might have to bring in one of my, they're not here, but I might have to come back to you with a technical explanation of this. But we haven't renegotiated any of our loans. All we've done is we've changed the way that we set the money aside for the repayment of debt. That's probably not very good for you, but we doesn't explain it. And as I say, I'll have to come back to you on that, I'm afraid. I haven't got that technical
expert. Okay, yeah, if you could turn it right to me, that'd be ideal. Because I'd like to do that with my mortgage, if that's possible. I'm sure if we can live, it sounds like a fantastic way to pay or not pay your debt back.
Okay.
I was waiting for the long answer.
Oh, yeah. The next one, another technical one really, is cost reduction from refinancing lender option, borrower option, which is known as logo loans. So, logo loans, lender option, borrower option, just means the lender has an option to call in these loans to be repaid any time. And if they do, there's no penalties for the council, so we can just repay them and refinance them with somebody else. The borrower option means, which is us, the council is the borrower, we have an option to say to the lender that we are going to terminate these loans at any time. The issue for that is the lender will say, that's fine, you're well within your rights to do that, but there are penalties on doing that. And they're quite significant penalties. So as a result, the lender won't call the loans in because we're paying quite high interest rates, but it's not in their interest to call them in. As the borrower, we have never wanted to terminate the loans because the penalties are so high. However, with the council's financial situation as it is, and because the interest rates are so high on these loans, so these loans were taken out in the late 90s when the financial boom occurred and interest rates were really, really high. At at the time, it was a good deal for council to enter into these loans because the banks were offering lower interest rates than the current interest rates that were available at the time. So at the time, it was a good deal for the council, and we were paying about 8% interest, and we locked into those. Some of those are locked in for quite a long time. It was about an average of about 28 years we were locked into those loans. We've got about 10 or 11 of these. Some of them will terminate early. So one of them is actually due up in 2022. The longest one we've got is due up in 2065. And we're paying an average of 6% on all of these loans together. Some of them are really high interest, as I say, about 8%. Now, if we wanted to borrow money today, in today's market, the interest rate we would pay is about 2.5%. So you can see on some of these loans, we're paying a really high interest rate. So the plan is that we would actually refinance them. So we would terminate the loans and pay the penalties to the lenders. But even if we did that, as a result of that, we could still save at least £2 million a year on what we're actually be paying back in interest. Okay.
Any more questions or comments? I think it's the time we've spent on other issues, and it's such a riveting presentation.
It's quite contentious, really, because we will have to pay significant penalties to these banks. As I say, we wouldn't do normally, but the fact that we will save quite a significant amount of money even by doing that.